Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger got some key support today for his health care reform plan, but there is still a lot of disagreement. KCRA3's Kevin Riggs is live at the state capitol with more for us. Kevin?
Well, Sarah, the legislature's special session on health care reform is off to a slow start here at the Capitol. Lawmakers had no formal talks on the issue today, but the key to any deal remains the answer to this question: who pays?
Down here for me.
For 17-month-old Kenneth Mason, a trip to this downtown Sacramento medical clinic is not without pain. An experience entirely appropriate to the pain that surrounds the effort to fix California's costly health care system. Nearly 7 million in the state have no coverage.
It is expensive, very expensive.
Is this something you can afford?
No, not something I can afford.
My income right now wouldn't cover me being able to afford to pay for medical coverage on my own.
Governor Schwarzenegger has called the legislature into special session this week, a form of overtime to hammer out a deal. Today he got support from the Los Angeles Chamber of Commerce for his plan.
If everyone is with shared responsibility, we can do it. If the employers participate, if the individuals participate, if the hospitals participate, doctors.
Schwarzenegger was anxious to trumpet the business group's support since he's talking about a 4% payroll fee or tax on employers. It's a move Capitol Republicans steadfastly oppose.
It is true that our caucus in both houses is not going to support a tax proposal, and not just because we're opposed to taxes per se, but because it's not getting at the root cause of the problem.
That root cause, Nilo says, is the escalating cost of medical bills. To pay for reforms, the governor's talking about a ballot measure perhaps asking voters to boost taxes on businesses, hospitals, and doctors.
Complicated in that you have to get to the voters, and the voters are going to have to approve significant increases in various fees and or taxes.
Back at the Sacramento clinic, the executive director says the problem can no longer be ignored.
Every developed Western democracy in the world has health coverage for everybody.
Again, the governor wants everybody to pay. Now, if the tax issue goes to the ballot, it will be a very tough sell, essentially convincing voters to raise their own taxes when most of those same voters already have their own health care coverage. Sarah, Edie, back to you.
All right, Kevin Riggs, thank you. State medical workers could be in for a big pay raise. A bill on the governor's desk would give workers raises ranging from $84 a month to more than $2,100 a month. State officials say the pay increase is needed to avoid shortages at the state's mental hospitals, veterans' homes, and centers for the developmentally disabled. The increase is expected to cost the state more than $60 million a year. Coming up tonight at 6:30, will the governor's health care plan fly with voters?